One of the things I really wanted to talk about today is wargaming, but for HR.
Oh.
So a lot of the clients that we're working with right now, the labor market's tight, right?
Right.
And HR is having a really hard time, and business leaders, a really hard time recruiting and retaining people. So I'd love to chat a little bit and learn from you, how can they apply wargaming to the war on talent and thinking about how they get really smart and prepared to both attract and retain top talent?
Yeah, so HR is a great application for wargaming. So if you think about where we are in the year, it's planning for HR managers, right? And they're looking at their talent for the coming year. Wargaming really lets you think about what is happening with the talent in your marketplace. So where are you losing talent? Where are you having challenges retaining and attracting talent?
Mm-hmm.
And the way to figure out kind of not only what you're doing and how it's impacting you, is look at your competition. So same thing as what we talked about before with general strategic planning and brand planning, with HR planning, what you could do is actually take a look at where you believe in your marketplace most of the talent that you really want is, either where you'd like to, you know, be able to bring them over to your company from, where you're losing them to, and really think about, again, take your hat off, put on that, you know, competitor that is really winning talent and retaining talent. What are they doing? Like, what are their HR practices for ongoing retention and incentives and training and development, all the things at each stage? Not only how are they attracting talent, but what are they doing that is making them one of the top places to work, or, you know, keeping their talent? So I feel like it applies. It's a great application, very, you know, similarly, but very focused on just everything about scenario planning on your talent and what could happen in the next year based on what your key competitors are doing. And then, then you take their hat off again, put yours back on, and what it does is helps you to understand what you might do differently so that your HR plan isn't the same as it always is, that you're kind of looking at it in a different way. So
I love that. I think that's a great idea. And I know a lot of times when I'm working with leadership teams, we talk about really getting to understand what's happening out in your ecosystem, in the industry, not just with competitors, but also with some of those emerging competitors that maybe don't know. So this is a great idea to have the HR team focus on, if they're working on performance management maybe, or if they're working on succession planning, what are other companies doing? Even whether they're, you know, true competitors or not, that you can learn from. And certainly those that are competing, you know, put yourself in those shoes. It also feels like it would be a fun way to engage in an exercise to innovate around that.
Yeah, it really is. I mean, we do some fun things, like, and especially with HR and talent, where when we invite the workshop team in, we give them a letter and they've just gotten a offer they couldn't refuse and they are now working at XYZ company. And so that day when they're planning, when they say we, they mean the competitor. At the end of the day, they get a letter saying, hey, you didn't sign an NDA. You get to come back and get a bigger promotion to come back to your existing company. And now you know what the other competitor is doing. How would you change your strategy? And people have fun with it. And it's, but at the end, it's amazing because you come out with a playbook of what you can do, and it helps you to jumpstart your planning. So I don't know. I'm a big fan, and it's a ton of fun.
That's great. Excellent. Well, thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed our walk and talk today. If you did, if you tried this tip, if you tried wargaming for HR, let us know. We'd love to start a conversation.